Welcome back to Cord Cutting Today for Thursday, March 5th, 2020. This is the daily video where we share some of today's top cord cutting stories, along with our thoughts and opinions about what's happening in the world of cord cutting. If you find this video helpful, hit that like button, and if you're new here, subscribe to Cord Cutters News for videos like this every day. When I last hosted Cord Cutting Today last week, we talked about YouTube TV potentially dropping Fox regional sports networks that were owned by Sinclair. Their dispute was over money, as usual, no surprise there. Basically, Sinclair was asking for more money than YouTube was willing to pay. So their dispute has continued, and the two, in the meantime, came to a short-term agreement. So that kept the channels on the service, while they worked through negotiations. Unfortunately, overnight, those Sinclair-owned Fox regional sports networks started to be dropped by YouTube TV. Most notably was the YES Network. So YES put out a statement on Twitter early this morning, basically putting the blame on both YouTube TV and Sinclair, which was pretty interesting. In that statement, YES also said that Sinclair has made a deal with YouTube TV to keep some of those regional sports networks on the service, but not all of them. If you're confused, you are not alone. I'm confused too. It seems like there's a lot of confusion everywhere, from sports fans and reporters all the way up to the networks, who are still questioning exactly what's happening and how this is all going to turn out. So right now we don't know exactly which channels will stay and which ones will go. YouTube TV has said that the removal will happen sometime today, so we will be closely watching that all day and waiting for any official announcements that we might get from either side. We'll be posting all of that over on cordcuttersnews.com, along with on our social media. So if you're not already following us, the links for all of those accounts are down below in the show notes. While we're waiting to get some official word on RSNs, let's move along to Comcast. The company is in the middle of an antitrust lawsuit, which is now going to trial. This started when digital ad platform Via Media claimed that Comcast was violating antitrust laws by forcing cable TV providers to purchase ads through Comcast, effectively preventing smaller ad companies from doing business specifically in areas around Chicago, Detroit, and Hartford. This case was previously dismissed in district court, but Via Media appealed that decision, and the decision was reversed. Now a jury is going to hear the case, and Via Media is asking for $160 million in damages. This is obviously far from the first time that we've heard of Comcast being in court. We're going to be keeping an eye on the trial, and personally, I'm interested to see if the results of this kind of set any kind of precedents for similar situations where a huge company can come in and smaller ad companies get basically pushed out, or whether companies like Comcast will just sort of keep going to court and dealing with this one case at a time. I'm interested to hear your thoughts, so if you have any opinions about that, share them in the comments down below. Next up, let's talk about BritBox. Now, if you aren't already familiar, BritBox is a streaming service with a large collection of British TV and movies for audiences outside of the UK. The service has popular shows like Midsummer Murders, along with a lot of original content. So yesterday we learned that BritBox has reached 1 million subscribers, so it has doubled its subscriber base in just over a year since January 2019. If you love British television, you can join 1 million other fans and sign up for a 7-day free trial before your $7 per month subscription begins. You can also sign up through Amazon channels. Another streaming service that I wanted to mention today is Frndly TV. Until yesterday, the $6 per month service had 13 channels, including Hallmark channels, The Weather Channel, and Game Show Network. Yesterday, it added CuriosityStream to the lineup. This is a service that's family-friendly, affordable, and really a good option as a secondary streaming service. If you're already subscribed to another service but you're missing a couple of those channels, Frndly TV makes a really great addition to your cord cutting setup and at an affordable price point. You'll get 14 live channels along with over 1,000 on-demand titles, and there's also a grid guide, there's a look back feature that can be really helpful, and there is unlimited cloud DVR. So if you haven't already checked that one out, click on the link down below for that post, and there's a link in there to Frndly TV. Before we wrap up for the day, I wanted to let you know about some classic content as well as some brand new content that's available to stream. Disney fans probably know that Disney opened up a new ride at their theme park yesterday. In celebration of the new ride, we put together a list of 10 classic Mickey movies and TV shows that are available to stream on Disney Plus. The list starts with Steamboat Willie, obviously, and continues with some other classics like Fantasia and other animations all the way up through the 2000s. Disney Plus also has some really cool documentaries that will give you an inside look at the parks. So they have everything from like how rides are put together to just sort of some behind the scenes things that you don't get to see every day. So they're really interesting. We have an older one and a newer one that are also both linked in that post. So to check out that full list of 10 titles plus documentaries, click on the link down below for that post. Finally, I wanted to mention a free ad-supported service that I really like personally, and I know a lot of you do too from the Facebook group, Crackle. They have released their March content calendar, and we've shared the entire thing over at Queer Cutters News. The free service has a couple of originals coming out this month, including one for sports fans and one for stand-up comedy lovers. There are also some exclusives that you'll only find over on Crackle, so there are a ton of movies also hitting the platform as well. Be sure to check that out if you're looking for something to watch this weekend without paying for another subscription. That's our show for today. Don't forget to head over to queercuttersnews.com for these full stories, updates, and much more. I'll be right here at my desk tomorrow for more news in the world of cord cutting.